So essentially, what you're saying here is the whole model is kind of broken.
I think it's a good start and it needs some refinement. So I think the first part on the top chart is really the good news, right? Of, for a while now, we've been operating the venture business without necessarily having enough angel funds or incubators, accelerators to provide a well-developed pipeline, right? And now that's beginning to fix itself. I don't think it's all the way there because, there need to be far many more angel and incubator investee companies than venture-backed companies, right? So it still has way to go, but 2006 when seen in comparison to 2012, there's clear progress in the base of the pyramid getting built, right? So I think that's the good news. The second chart really, and the couple of observations on those are linked to what will make this more effective, right? And really, as I said, there are two points to note here. One is when you go from angel financing to venture financing, right? And this is a two-year view. One could argue that beyond 2 years, there is a little bit more that can flow here. But roughly 20-25% of the companies are getting financed at the venture stage, right? Whereas the valuation gap between angel financing and venture financing seems to be about 4x, right? Now, that math does not work. So angel financing really has to be more productive, either in terms of how many companies do they graduate into venture, right? Or in terms of the valuation difference between angel stage and venture stage, which means more progress before you go out and raise capital, right? So I think that's one lever that needs to get tweaked for this to work. If it does not, and angel investors realize that there's money, more money to be made at venture stage and with less risk, you'll start contraction, seeing contraction here. The second piece which is important here is as you look at incubators and accelerators, most of them are signing up for a 6 months or less engagement with the company. It does not seem that the startup velocity in India is fast enough to leverage that, right? So on an average, we are seeing 1.5 to 2 years from the beginning of incubation and acceleration to get to the angel stage. So really, I think incubators and accelerators, we need to look at how do we continue to support these companies and really accelerate these companies over an 18-month period rather than accelerate them just over 6 months and then over the next 12 months they're on their own, right? So I think that will improve the effectiveness of this funnel because support is available for as long as needed rather than just for the 4 to 6 month period. And that 4 to 6 month period works great in the US market where velocity is higher, VC competition is higher. But in the Indian market, that seems like it's too short a duration.
So if you look at the second chart, so you're saying, so out of 100 companies which raise seed funding, 16% shut down.
Yeah, within a 1 year from graduation time frame.
Okay. And 19% goes back into the seed stage.
Yeah. So, they might have gone into one accelerator from there, they might go to another accelerator or another incubator, right?
And 27% graduate to the angel financing level.
Right.
And at the angel financing level, you'll have 9% again shutting down, 28% coming back to
raising, 1 crore or thereabout, another angel-like round.
And 20% go on to the
Series A.
Series A round.
Yeah.
Now, the difference between here and here is what you said, a valuation gap, right?
No. So everywhere there is a valuation gap. So seed financing are typically happening at a 1 crore valuation, right? People put 10 lakhs and they get 10% of the company. Angel financings are happening at about 6-7 crores. Series A is happening at 20-25 crores, right? Now, if I'm getting a 7x markup between seed and angel, and 1/4 of my companies are going through, then 7 multiplied by 1/4 is still more than one. So I'm making money. But if I'm getting 1/4 of the companies through and getting a 4x markup, then I'm not making any money. I'm even, right, or less. So the challenge in terms of valuation and graduation seems to be more from angel to Series A than necessarily from incubators and accelerators.
Okay.
The incubator accelerator problem has more to do with velocity of startups, right?
Mm.
Because I think if the incubators and accelerators are willing to support their startups for longer, they will see even more productivity going forward.
So essentially what you're saying is you need to create more companies at the angel stage that graduate to the Series A level?
Yeah, okay. As a percentage. So if today 20% is graduating or 25% is graduating, you need to take that number to 30-35%. Or you need to create more value, which is your Series A company should be commanding 35 crores of valuation, not 20-25 crores of valuation.
But current levels indicate that it's pretty much none of the angel guys are making a lot of money.
No, so this is the industry overview, right? Within that, there'll be people who are in the money, there'll be people who are not in the money, it'll be a mix. So this is not commenting on any specific angel fund, right? But this is a survey across five of the large angel funds, right? And collectively, this is the picture that emerges, right? But within that, are there angel investors who are making a lot of money? Sure.
So this is a survey of five angel groups?
Five large angel funds. Angel funds or groups.
Group.
And this again is five large incubators or accelerators.
Incubators.
Because we have given the incubators accelerators 1 year after graduation and we have given angel financings 2 years after the funding, you know, these obviously are the ones who have been around for a while, right? We could not go and survey people who have started only 1 year back because they have not had enough time for us to do the analysis on.
Great. From the seed to angel stage, what you need to do is increase the
support.
Duration of engagement from
right.
6 months to 18 months or so.
12 to 18 months,
12
yeah.
to 18
yeah.
months or so. Yeah. And from here, you're talking about more number of...
Higher staff. Graduation rates. So once you've invested in a company, you need to focus on what it takes for them to raise Series A financing, right? And at the selection stage itself, screen companies which will get all the way rather than not.
And now, coming to this chart, in 2006, there were 7 angel funds.
Active angel funds.
Active angel funds. And and at the same time, you had 43 active angel,
venture investors.
And in 2012, you have 32 angel funds, active funds, and
48 venture investors.
Venture investors. So this number doesn't seem to have grown a lot.
Which is fine. If you just look back on 2006-7 to 2012, there are not a lot of VCs who have come to the market. Right?
Yeah.
Most of us came to the market in the 2006-7 time frame.
Yeah.
And after that, there are not too many people who have come in afresh. And really, I think that is a function of what exits do we see in the next couple of years. If we see a lot of exits in the next couple of years, you will see more VCs coming. If you see a dearth of exits in the next couple of years, you might see some of the VCs going up, right? So I think the VC market is by and large stable at this point, and really the exits in the next 2 years, 3 years will determine whether it increases or decreases. But it's encouraging to see the angel market and the incubator accelerator market grow significantly in the last 5-6 years.
But in the coming days, you need this number to grow from 32 to what?
Either this number or the number of companies.
Yeah.
See, this is the number of investors.
Yeah.
But in a healthy market, you know, you should have 5 to 10 times the number of angel investee companies every year relative to venture investee companies. Now, in India, there are 60-70 new Series A investments happening every year, right? So there should be 500 angel investments every year for the pyramid to be balanced.
But how many do you think are we doing right now?
Today, it's under 100.
Wow, so that's a big gap.
And again, I'm talking about organized angel groups. It's very hard to track investments that an individual is making, right? But that number needs to get in the 500 to 1,000 range.